court, breaking his own. Got the Nikonians in. Just about set. Bit of movement, shuffling going on there near the middle of the line. The stalls are open, though. They're off. They're racing. Moet de Vega jumped quickly, headed, though, by the Nikonian Sterling Estate. He's riding the ears off. Count to Moz off to be right over the speed. Further back is One Short Saturday Sun, also pushing up Mirror Moon, who's going up now in advance of, on the outside, Dolly M around them wider. Pleto getting shuffled right back into the field with Tonka Tough, Amaliago. And last of all is Rose Thief, as they'd sorted themselves out heading past the 700. It's the Nikonian that leads the way by a length on Count to Moz off. 1.5 away. Then on the inside is Moet de Vega. Over on the outside then, coming towards the home turn, going up next of all, Sterling Estate in front of Dolly M, One Short. Back on the inside is, at the head of the others to the turn, Regal Moon, being followed by Saturday Sun in the middle. One Short, Tonka Tough to the outside. Now Pike has worked his way around heels. He's come right to the outside here to try and make ground on these leaders. The Nikonian taken on by Count de Moz off, which had reached the lead. Here comes the charge from Tonka Tough and Pleto as well, right down the outside. It's Pleto going up, passing the 100, reaching the lead, pulling away and proving to be much too good. Pleto the hot pot beat home Saturday Sun, who cut right back to the inside to grab second, I'd say, from either Count de Moz off or Tonka Tough and Amaliago deep out. And then Sterling Estate, followed by One Short, Rose Thief, Moet de Vega. In behind them, Regal Moon, knocking right up is the Nikonian, and likewise Dolly M, who was forced to cover plenty of extra ground. No doubts at all in regards to the favourite there, justifying the awfully short price. Pleto, William Pike, putting them away effectively in the last little bit to go on and record her third win from seven starts. 12 Pleto, the playing god mare from Storm Leto in the Mungrup stud colours, along with Nigel Ride, G.R. Manasco, trained by Dan and Ben Pierce. William Pike there at the back end of the season, just adding a little more fruit to the sideboard on what has been another awfully successful year for him. Saturday Sun got right up on the inside to grab second, and either Tonka Tough, Count to Moz off for third placing from Amaliago. 12-10, 2-9 they are. 12-10, 2-9. Tonka Tough grabbing fourth from Amaliago. Margins were 2 3/4, with a head splitting second and third. 1:13.42 recorded for the 1200, 36.48 that sectional. The runner-up, Saturday Sun, Sean O'Donnell, the rider for Dave Harrison, a Nikonian three-year-old, and two Count to Moz off, weighs in third by Viscount out of National Glory, again from Dave Harrison's stable, ridden by Joe Azzopardi. But no doubts about the winner, Pleto, who ran 150 on the WOP. The Penfolds handicap, race seven next at 4:15, and a field of 14 to run. No alterations to come there. Let's go back and catch up with Brittany here after this very, very comfortable win by Pleto. She conceded them a start, but Pike worked his way seemingly towards the better part of the track this afternoon here at Belmont Park to allow the favourite every opportunity.
It would appear so, Darren. I have Dan Pierce with me now after the victory of Pleto. And Dan, what were your thoughts during the run?
We left it up to Pikey a bit, drawn a little bit sticky, and he was confident there'd be a fair bit of speed. It is good to see her hit the line like that and not be one-dimensional and just have to go forward. So the fact she could get back and run through the line is really pleasing.
She drew the wide gate first up and really couldn't have been any more impressive. Were you worried that that sort of gut-busting effort could have taken a little bit out of her first up?
Well, we initially did think to go 3 weeks between a run and give her a bit of time, but she did really well and put in a really good gallop. So we're on for this and went this way. So it's worked out.
Does that give you promise that she's come back an even tougher sort of mare?
Yeah, I think so. She got a bit crook last prep and had to have a long time on the sidelines. So she's obviously well and truly over that, and maybe the time's done her good.
You look to head to a Saturday now?
I think so. We'll just have a look and just work through the grades and pick some out.
Congratulations on the win.
Thank you.
Dan Pierce after the victory of Pleto. It was a nice performance by the mare, and we said just before the race that Little Heath at Mungrup, they posted the video that when he was cheering her home to third place first up. Well, I think he would have been pretty happy with the victory there by Pleto, because I must admit, Scott, there are a few moments there that we said to each other in the run, well, we'll see how good she is from here, because She just didn't look to be travelling all that well, but gee, the way that as soon as she saw daylight in the straight, she showed the classy horse she is.
Yeah, she certainly did, Britton. I think one of the more exciting parts about her is that she's quite versatile as well. She can race on the speed, she can race off the speed. So expecting to see Pletto go right through the grades, she looks like a Saturday mare in the making for sure.
A nice victory by Pletto here, justifying favouritism. We'll take a break on Sky Thoroughbred Central. And when we come back, we'll have a look at some replays for races 7 and 8.